today what the Beatles were to us 26 years ago. They are the hottest young singing sensation that hit this country. And they are breaking hearts. They are New Kids on the Block.
What I'm going to do.
kind of girl are you looking for? And have you ever dated a fan?
Well, I don't really talk. We don't really, you know, talk too much about who we've dated. But I've seen like at least 20 girls in the crowd today who I would date. Maybe more than 20. You know what I mean?
This, Jonathan, I imagine it's hard for the girls to get to you because we noticed your whole posse, the bodyguard, everybody. So it's kind of, this is going to be a long hour. Is it hard to get to meet a girl now and know that she's interested in you and not this whole star trip?
If you really want to get involved with someone, you really got to give them a try. So we're definitely going to give someone a try. We can't be prejudiced.
Okay. What I want to know is, so the kind of girl you're looking for is she smart? Is she tall? Is she pretty? Is she sensitive?
I can't say that personally. I have a type of girl. I just like women, girls, period. I don't care what they look like. I think that now when everyone always asks us that, you know, how can you tell if a girl's sensitive? I think it's even now. Now that we have all this success and we're worried about girls who only like us because of our success, I think it's even because girls have always throughout time been worried about whether guys only want them for one thing. So now when we meet a girl, they worry whether we want them for that one thing, and we have to worry the same thing. So now it's even. I like it that way because it's even. You know what I'm saying?
Person's dream is to be famous, you know what I mean? I mean,
to meet you,
Kim. I mean, who wouldn't want to be admired by, you know, so many people?
Yeah.
It's
And so Joey, does it ever get to you though? Does it ever get to you? Do you just want some peace and quiet sometimes? I've lost my hearing and voice in 2 minutes.
So there are times when you want to get away, and there are times that you can do that. And those are the times that save you, because everyone wants to, you know, just chill out for a little while. But I mean, no one, you can't replace what's happened to us, and you can't replace this. So while we have it, we're gonna keep it, and we're not gonna.
I often wonder.
Like applaud every time you say something, because all that time that you used doing that, we can answer that many more questions.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Thank you for that. Let me ask you this. Wait a minute, girls. He's absolutely right. If you're gonna scream every time they breathe, then this is gonna be a long hour, and you're not gonna get your questions answered. What I wanted to ask, what has been the greatest thing about becoming famous so quickly, and also the worst thing? The greatest thing is, Danny, the greatest thing has been, really.
I think the greatest thing.
Okay.
It's just that since we've been together, we've always loved performing, and now the greatest thing is that we can perform in front of like 20,000 people every night, you know, and that's And that's the time we can give something back to the fans. So.
No, the thing that I loved about you guys when I was reading your story, and I'm glad you wrote your story so that other people don't have to keep saying things that are not true, but the thing that I sensed the most when I read that book that you guys just put out is that you all have such a great sense of family. And then we had your moms on, and you're just, you know, you have to love a guy who loves his mom. Because, think that because all of you have really done really great things for your moms, and I want you to just go down the line and tell us what you did for your parents. I want to hear it.
Let's start with the Knights, because they went off. They were
crazy. Let's start with the Knights. What did the Knights do? What did you guys do?
Well,
part of a little house.
A little house.
What'd you do?
Just a little one.
Because you all grew up in a house where everybody used the same bathroom. Is that true? Was it one bathroom? And there was about 29 people in the house?
Yeah.
Much people.
Now we got a bathroom for every day of the week. But,
That's great. And that must feel good to be able to do that.
Yeah, it feels real good. And recently my mother turned 50, so me and Jordan had a big party at our house. And
we had a
50s party, and we bought our brand new car for her birthday, so.
That's great. That's great. Joey?
Well, I guess there's a lot of people out there that say it's not environmentally sound, but, ever since I got in the group or whatever, she always wanted a fur coat, so this was like years ago. That was the first thing I ever got. It was the fur coat, and I gave it to her Christmas Eve.
Did you give her pearls and things too?
Oh, I give her, stuff. We all do little things for her.
And aren't you expanding the house?
Yeah, I bought the house that we grew up in.
That's great.
From my parents, and now they retired from their jobs, and they just shop.
I bought my mother a house first because we lived like in a very, very small apartment, and we had to get out. So I got my mother a house, and then my mother and father are divorced, so just about 2 months ago, I just bought my father a house also in Milton, which is like a place that, it felt good to do that because, we always live right on the outskirts of Milton, and you drive through and you're like, man, someday I'm going to own a house there. And it's like a pipe dream. It's never going
to
happen.
Yeah, I used to go around and pick the houses you'd like to live in.
Yeah, but it happened now. And
now you can buy the block.
Do that.
Next, which new kid is used to missing his underwear? We'll be back in a moment. First sign that a girl's liking you for the wrong reasons?
She has to meet someone else.
Oh.
Can I meet Jordan now?
Also, a lot of girls, the first thing they try and tell you is, I don't like you for who you are. When they're so defensive about it right off the bat, it kind of tells you, it's like, well, they just came to the concert, they got your button on, and they're coming to the hotel, and they say, you're in the hotel lobby, you walk in through, they say, I don't like you for you, I just like you because you're really nice. No, I don't mind if people like me for what we're doing, that's okay, because that's a good quality.
We have met fans that were nice, and maybe we would have been interested in dating, but, we're traveling from city to city, so it's...
What is the strangest thing that's happened while you're on tour, traveling from city to city? Because I can imagine that you can't really go out a lot, so you all have to stick together, and you have to really like each other a lot to do that, don't you?
We have to have a lot of arguments, too.
Yeah.
Really?
We go out.
We walked down the street the other day, remember?
Yeah.
Someone flattened that tire, though.
Yeah, someone flattened that tire.
Jacob's ladder.
Yeah.
They gave two thumbs down to Jacob's ladder.
Yeah.
I would like for each of you to describe each other. For instance,
Yeah.
Danny, yeah, you can pick your favorite guy to describe. So I want you, so tell us something we really don't know, that we can't read in the book, that we haven't heard.
Jordan and I actually think alike. He's very, very hot. Yes.
Does he make you laugh?
Yeah, Jordan. See, the thing about Jordan is.
I am.
Jordan's quiet, but he has all the leadership qualities of a great leader. It's just his quietness is what makes people sometimes not really dig where he's coming from. But Jordan is like, he's pretty much on the ball. I mean, he could sit here this whole show and not say one word. And then at the right time, he will just say one statement that'll be so significant that it tells you that he was there.
Okay, Joey, I see you getting ready. Who are you going to describe?
Donnie, because first of all, Donnie, I used to always, I don't know, Donnie always used to say I was like his little brother, and he used to, you know, try to, you know, guide me in the right way and this and that. So I will take this opportunity to say that. You see Donnie because he's very dominant and upfront, and people can read him right away, and he always has something great to say, and I just think that, one thing...
Say it, Joe.
He's like, I think one thing I always said is he's great with the fans. I think, although he's not, you know, he's just real good with the fans, and he knows how to deal most the best with the
fans. What is it about him?
What do I like most about him? Well, first of all, he's a very funny guy. He's a very funny dude. Second of all, you know, he's just, I think, you know, he's always down to do, you know.
Is he the one that keeps you guys in line? There's always some, out of a group, there's somebody
well,
that says,
I
okay.
Think, I think so. Everybody always said John.
Too many stories.
No, but I think we all try to.
We all keep each other.
Yeah, that, but I.
You
just
all help each other. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
But
Jonathan,
that's
who
Donnie
you
in a nutshell.
Well, today we have Joe. He's wearing a green suit and blue eyes. I think me and Joe, we've. When in the beginning stages, me and Joe weren't really close, but I think more and more we've gotten a lot closer. I think
And why weren't you close in the beginning? Because he was the newest
new
kid.
No, not just that, but Joe was such an age difference. Mm-hmm. You know, you were like 12 and I was 16, and when you're younger, it makes a big difference. Mm-hmm. But now I think, you know, that I'm 22 and he's 18, it kind of bridges.
21 and 17.
The gap smaller.
Okay, when we come back.
Other than that,
Danny is going to speak. Jonathan.
Oh, right. well, John, he's the eldest member of the group, so he's very mature. He's also shy, but when you really get to know him, he's not really shy.
What do you have to say about Danny? See, you seem shy. But you're not.
Danny is, first of all, he's a nice guy and I love him. he's very determined and very, very ambitious.
Yeah.
And he's very
group. Didn't you put off going to Boston College? You just put that off, right? You put that on hold for a while?
Yeah.
Be you.
And he's very group orientated.
Really?
Yeah.
You got muscle.
Aren't you graduating this year?
I'm graduating this year.
You're graduating this year. So does a tutor travel on the road with you?
Yeah.
And so you have to study in between concerts still? Yeah.
Kind of.
Sort of. Do these guys help? Oh, you guys have to do it too. What are you on for? And you're planning on going to college?
Well, I was going to Boston University.
Mm-hmm.
I have a 4-year scholarship there, but, you know, I'm going to do this first and then see what happens.
Well, good.
When you have concerts 4 nights in a row, do you still have a tutor teach you between
the
concerts?
Yeah, we have it during the day, because it's just, I mean, we do shows every night, so it's pretty much like anything else, so it's, yeah, I do it every day. I try to, anyways. It's hard,
okay,
though.
Okay, this is for Joe. I heard that you were going out with a girl from Boston College.
I said in the yeah, thank you. I don't have to, but I never meant that I wouldn't want to see any other girl. I was seeing a girl met her one day, right? And I said no. I said hi, right? And that was it. That was the end of it.
It's like we go on dates sometimes.
Yeah,
you know,
sometimes.
When we go home, we go on dates like anybody else.
Yeah, but it was weird. I mean, I think it's unfair to us. I mean, I know how people would feel if we did have girlfriends, but we're just as human as everybody else.
But, I never lived with her or anything. My mother would kill me if I didn't.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, this is for Donnie. Do you ever feel obligated to watch and say what you do, because like so many people are watching you, and I mean, and if you make a wrong move, I mean, and people might take that in a bad way. Do you ever feel that you have to watch what you say to the press and everybody, all your fans?
Well, that's true.
You know, I think there is a responsibility to an extent, but I think the thing about this group is that this is not like an act. It's not an act for us to be saying, you know, that we don't use drugs, that we stay away from drugs. This is not an act. And so the things that we
because
say
you do
are
stay
very
away
real.
From drugs. You do stay away from drugs.
Yeah, we do stay away from drugs. And the things that we say are very real. So it's not like there's anything that we have to hide or anything that, you know, I mean, you watch what you say in the sense that, I mean, you just try and be respectful of a situation, but the fans have always accepted us for us, and other people like the newspapers and stuff, they don't always understand that. So if something bad happens, like Donnie defends himself or something like that, the press wants to make it more than it is, but the fans know that we take a lot of flack for doing what we're doing, and some of us just don't want to accept that. You know, we want to stand up for
ourselves. Yeah, do you find it hard to live up to, because people are just people, no matter who you are, and I think the press sort of decided that you were going to be crispy clean.
No one can live up to the newspaper standards. I mean, you know that yourself, because
no,
you're
not
on the cover of every tabloid every week. I mean, it's just the standards that we set for ourselves is to be ourselves, and the fans know that. And you know, I mean, everyone has rumors. You have rumors. We have rumors. It's just, it's when you get in the spotlight, you're gonna get that.
Yeah,
but
and would you feel that when you're in
ourselves.
When you're in the spotlight, every little thing you do is blown out of proportion?
Exactly.
Do you feel that?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But
is that the worst part of it for you, not being able to really be?
Yeah, the worst part is the lack of privacy.
Yeah.
And just being self-conscious wherever you go and having to watch what you say. you know.
Because if somebody's messing with you and you tell them to get out of your way.
You can't touch anyone. You can't even push someone. You can't even, like, if they came up in your face and said, I hate you, you're a sucker, you can't even push them because you just got to walk away. Because there's so much, if you do that one push, exactly. If you do that one push, it's over.
Yes,
question?
Okay,
you guys all said you're single. Well, I'm free. So. Is it true that on your next album you might be singing a song with Frank Sinatra?
That's what, no, actually, Maurice, our producer, Maurice Starr, he was, I guess he's going to work with Frank Sinatra. And I always, myself, I always love Frank Sinatra and I love what he does. And he's, I get a lot
don't
out
you
of
give
him.
Frank, don't you do Frank Sinatra? Didn't I read that you do Frank Sinatra?
I sing, I get all his taste and I sing with him.
Okay, I just want one line.
What song should I sing? What song? What song?
Okay, any song. My Way.
Oh, I don't know that song.
Okay, any song. Chicago. You're in Chicago, that's good. You know that? Any song.
In the night.
Okay, how about that? I like that.
Now, you might say, wow, I didn't know his voice was that low, but it is that low.
Okay.
All right,
okay.
Can't believe I'm doing this on national TV. Do I get any bonuses for this? I don't even want to do it.
The Frank Sinatra imitation. Yes.
I gotta feel Frank. I gotta like. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Alright, I wish I had some music, but Strangers in the Night. And learned this song with my father, so let me give this to my father.
Okay.
Since he's lost it. Strangers in the night, exchanging glances, wandering in the night, what were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through? Thank you very much. I hope Frank sees that. Gives me a record, dear.
Okay. Now, what's this about you have? Whose underwear do you have? Is anybody missing any underwear up here?
Me.
Can I give something back?
Oh, she's going
to
show them?
You can just tell me what you have.
I have Danny's underwear.
Danny. Danny would like his underwear back.
He would like his underwear back?
on several issues regarding children. Just recently, the New Kids on the Block traveled to Chile for Amnesty International's Call for Freedom. I want you to take a look at this. Little did they know that their fans in Chile were so abundant.
It was different. It was like, it was surprising because we didn't know what to expect going down there. And it was just like, we've gone around the world in Europe. We've had like crazy fanatical fans and everywhere. But Chile, we just didn't expect it. And
how was it different?
They were just, maybe because the situation in Chile, they've really never had anything like that down there.
Uh-huh.
That they were so really excited. But I mean, they did stuff. They were like on top of the buses. I mean, they were doing it. It was really unusual.
Yeah, you wanted to say what? Yeah?
I myself am I'm a political refugee in the United States for already 15 years. And when I heard you guys are going over there, I was touched. You know, I know you don't know me, but I know you are doing it for everybody else. And I really love you for doing that.
That's dope. Thanks.
I want to ask you about your favorite word. Positivity. Who invented that word?
What?
Positivity. You did, Donnie?
I think I did.
Yeah. And that was all about what? You just wanted to...
Well, that's just about, you know, just about us. That's the true message of New Kids on the Block is positivity. It's not about, we're trying to be, with anti-drug crusades or anything like that. I mean, we just have certain beliefs, and our beliefs are positive. We're not trying to be goody two-shoes and all that. We're just trying to be us. And by being positive, you know, some people have taken it in a good way and some people have tried to make it out to be a bad way. But being positive can only be a good thing because, I mean, that's the only way the world can get better is by positivity.
I believe that. I wanted to ask you the worst negative thing that you have heard that you want to refute or say something about right here. The thing that has made you the maddest that you just want to say, oh, man.
Oh, I got one.
What is it, Joey?
We can't say enough about what our producer Maurice Starr has done for us. And he's just a very creative man, and he's done a lot for us, and he's done a lot for a lot of people in the music business. But I think I just get so furious when people that don't even know us, never been to our show, never seen us, say that we're just puppets and we just do what Maurice tells us to do. He never taught us how to dance.
Yeah.
He never taught us how to rap. He never taught us how to be us.
Danny, you were breakdancing long before.
We all were doing something before we met Maurice Starr. Mm-hmm. We all had some kind of talent.
I mean, but I don't want to take anything away from Maurice, and I think his record shows for what he's done, but I just don't want people...
I think what's happened is that the album is sort of the philosophy of Step by Step is that you really are sort of growing step by step too, isn't that true?
Right, mm-hmm. Exactly. Yeah. But see, the thing is that it's...
I'll let you say that when I come back.
Good.
I gotta go to break, Donnie. Thank you. For the New Kids on the Block and a man who has been with the kids since the very beginning. We're glad to have you join us today. The new kids were on our show about a year and a half ago, and I'm telling you, they were great, but there was not this kind of pandemonium. I haven't seen anything like this since the Beatles, and you all get compared a lot to the whole phenomenon of the Beatles. How do you explain it?
Well, I think the time was right.
Yeah.
That the kids came at a time when America and the whole world was waiting for a group like this with positive values and clean, wholesome American guys. I think they are the perfect American group.
And you manage everything for them, right? You make sure that their money is taken care of, that they're doing the right thing with it, that they're not going to be foolish, and that they'll have money for years
to come. That it's a conglomerate of people. See, no one person is responsible.
Now, are the guys on allowance, or do they just get to spend what they want?
Well, they're growing into their spending habits.
I saw Jonathan with that cashmere jacket on. I guess.
Well, they love clothes. I think all of them love clothes, except maybe Donnie and Danny, as you can tell. That's right. as you can see from their prison attire, they don't really care that much about clothes. But I think they all have individual taste. And I think Joseph is probably the most concerned about clothing and
to be able to buy anything you want now, because one of the things that touched me in our story that you guys wrote was the story of the, tell them about the Christmas present your mom got that year, mom and dad.
Oh, that they got for us?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, the
we
bikes.
All, thank you.
Now, that's a picture that will be in my head forever. It's just because it's like, I learned from my parents, you know, the values I have, I got them from my parents. And
you never said what it was. They said what
well,
it was.
Right. Well, my parents, one Christmas, gave every kid in the family a bike. And at the time, that was rough because our family, like, you know, it would be a struggle all year round.
So it took them a year to pay for all of
it. It took them a year to build up the money to have a good Christmas. But every year, there was, like, an amazing Christmas. And that I learned that, and that's what I feel now. I got all this money, but it's more fun for me to do for my family than it is to do for myself.
John, I was wondering, are you guys going to be home for, like, the holidays and Christmas?
Yeah, we're going to be home for Thanksgiving, and then Christmas time, we're going to be home for maybe 3 or 4 days.
Just one day, though.
Just one day, and then you're back
on
the road.
Her face lit up like, oh, I'm going to go to Boston for Thanksgiving.
So, Dick, do you determine how many days they can be on the road and how many is too many?
No.
He doesn't know what too many means.
So that's
one
boy.
It's like,
get out on that stage, boy.
New York, you're going all around the country. I wish you the continued success that you've had. I mean, if you get any hotter, we won't be able to stand it. What is the one thing you want people to know most about New Kids on the Block?
I would like to say one thing about our fans. Our fans, all fans get a little extreme. I think stealing Danny's underwear is a little extreme. But our fans are just like all other fans, and they've been criticized a lot, and we've been criticized for them because they're so young and they scream and they carry on. But everyone who has fans, like Luther Vandross, Guns N' Roses, have all different fans of all
and
different
you love
age
your
groups
fans.
Who act the same way.
Yep.
It's just for a different group, and it's just a different thing. I mean, when Luther Vandross sat here, the whole crowd was carrying on and screaming.
Not like this.
Well, this is just...
This is Tim Throckmorton, Channel 5 Sports. Join me for the latest in...